a look at Congressman Murphy today in exchange with Jonathan Silver, the executive director of the Energy Department's Loan Programs Office.
Well, we talked, this staff talked with the company on a regular
basis. Sir, I really want you to stop throwing everybody else under the bus. I hear you throwing all your staff under the bus. I want to know, you're in charge, you've handled loans of this size, and now you're saying it's everybody else's fault but you, except you're in charge. You tell me what you, as a person in charge, did with $500 million of taxpayers' money, now saying it's all my staff's fault, I didn't know, I can't do anything about it.
Joining me live from Washington, Republican Congressman Tim Murphy. So, thanks for being with us, Congressman. Solyndra represents just over 1% of the loan guarantees under that Energy Department program. It's the only one that's gone bad. You know, the White House is saying, look, sometimes businesses fail. In your opinion, what makes it different?
It makes it different because in January of 2009, the credit group already voted unanimously to say this is not good. And it was a couple weeks later that suddenly that decision was reversed. And also in September of that year, you saw the email that says this whole company is going to be out of money in 2011. Now, Mr. Silver came on board in November and he said it wasn't my fault, everybody came before me. But he also said shortly after that exchange we had that they didn't get one check. The checks kept coming, even though comment after comment was showing this company wasn't doing well. They didn't have the money. They went to restructure loans. And this is when a real bomb went off here, too. The law clearly says that we pass that they cannot change where the money goes to if the company goes belly up. It was supposed to be the taxpayers get repaid first. What he said was their lawyers advised them they did not have to pay attention to that law, changed it, so the private investors got their money first. So a number of things began to occur here, which shows the taxpayers are out of $535 million. The other investors get their money back. We may not see any of that. And so it's all these other elements. It isn't whether or not the company could survive. And some of them don't. The issue was there was lots of signs before the first checks were written that it wasn't going to work, and lots of signs after the checks were being written to say we shouldn't go any farther.
So is it your belief that the Obama administration basically was just pushing this deal forward because they so much wanted to be seen as doing something, or they so much wanted to promote green energy, they felt this was like the perfect company to give a large amount of money to?
Well, I don't know what was in the minds or hearts of the Obama administration, but it was clear to me in talking to Mr. Silver that here's a man who talked about with the companies that he had been a major player in. There were entrepreneurial capital, that he was used to loans of this size more. And clearly, if you're involved with investing private people's money, at some point, if you say, look, we shouldn't throw good money after bad because this company can't survive, you can't do what he simply said in this as well, but this was all about building the building on time. You had to fill the building with people and products and make it happen. And it was clear to me from what he was saying is he had information before him from staff that were saying it couldn't work, but then he said, well, it was the staff's fault. And then when it came time to change the law, he said, well, it was the lawyer's fault, not his. And that's what really troubled us a lot.
But this program existed under the Bush administration. Was it a problem then, or do you think it's just something about the way it's being executed on this particular deal?
Well, the program came through under the Energy Bill of 2005, but that was setting it up. The money actually was coming through later on. What occurred here, however, was the folks before President Obama took office in January of 2009, they said, don't go any further. We're unanimously voting not to do this. And it was a couple weeks later, after the inauguration of President Obama, that came through. Now, let the facts speak for themselves. I don't know if there's a link there or not. What I do know is pretty clear, that there was substantial and repetitive evidence from people within the organization of DOE, Department of Energy, saying, this is not going well. This company cannot survive. And they kept putting money into it.
Congressman Tim Murphy, I appreciate you joining us tonight. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Anderson. I appreciate you showing light on this.